My name is Dana Goldstein. I'm the founder of PhilanTrack, and we have created the PhilanTrack online grants management system that helps nonprofits get more grants and reduces the transaction cost of grants administration in the nonprofit sector so that more money goes to fund programs and services and ultimately social impact rather than funding grants administration. So just to start out, how many of you have worked for a nonprofit? Okay, a good number of you, actually a surprising number for a tech-oriented crowd. How many of you have written grant proposals? Okay, also a good number of you. So this might look familiar to you if you've written grant proposals, or this. And it probably made you feel like this. So writing grant proposals, for those of you who are not familiar with it, is an incredibly labor-intensive, time-consuming process. And nonprofits, for the most part, and the organizations that fund them, are still using paper. So again, for those of you who are not as familiar with the nonprofit sector or as familiar with the grant process, it typically works like this. A nonprofit is looking for funding for its programs. It will try to find funders, foundations, government, corporations that are willing to fund the type of program that it does and the location where it's operating. That process is fairly time consuming. It then writes a grant proposal. And the process of writing a grant proposal is typically happening kind of like that. It's really labor intensive, really time consuming. If the nonprofit is lucky enough to get the grant, it then has to report on that grant, generally semi-annually. And the process is as labor intensive and time consuming as the proposal writing process. And it's actually so labor intensive and time consuming that nonprofits are spending up to 44% of their time and up to 11% of their overall budget just complying with funder requirements. And I'd be happy to talk with the city about ways that we can work with them. Specifically looking at the foundation grant writing process, foundations in the US award about $47 billion in grants annually, and 13% of every foundation grant dollar is spent administering the grants. So across the nonprofit sector, that's $6 billion a year that isn't being spent on programs and services and is being spent on grants administration. And that's happening because nonprofits are essentially reinventing wheels. Each time they're putting together a new grant proposal, each time they're approaching a new funder, they're going through the same process over and over again in a really, really inefficient way. And I realize that back office support for nonprofits isn't all that sexy, but it's critically important. So the nonprofit sector is very large. Nonprofits rely very heavily on grants as a source of funding. 40% of nonprofits report that over a quarter of their annual budgets comes from grants. So this process of reinventing wheels is really costly in terms of the social impact that the organizations are trying to achieve. So to get a little bit more concrete about it, the process of applying for grants looks a little bit like this. So say you're a nonprofit A, you've found these three foundations that may want to support your organization. In order to approach those foundations, you're writing different grant proposals in slightly different formats. You're using some combination of Word, Excel, whatever calendaring system, so you know Outlook or Google Calendar, to keep track of deadlines. You're missing deadlines because you're not sure where things are. They're somewhere on your organization's G drive, or they're on your executive director's laptop that she has. It's a mess. This is where PhilanTrack comes in. PhilanTrack sits in the middle of the process. It's a web-based grants administration tool that is uniquely designed to reduce the transaction costs and streamline grants administration for both the grant makers, who are the foundations, and the grant seekers, who are the nonprofits. So rather than continuing to talk about it, let me show you the system, give you a little bit of a sense of how it works. And I'll try to get the screen to the right size here. All right, well, it's not perfect, but it will do. So I'm logged in here as Arts After School. Arts After School is a fictitious organization, but they do after-school programs. They're in the Philly area. And they are looking for funding. They rely fairly heavily on grant funding. So you can see here, just on the homepage, they can immediately see what proposals are due when their final reports are due. And when I show this to nonprofits, they almost universally say, oh, that's great, I won't miss any more deadlines. So to help them not miss deadlines, we have a calendar that obviously shows today's date, and the kind of yellow highlights here are due dates for proposals and progress reports. And the nonprofit will get an automated email reminder prior to a due date, just to let them know that they should be logging into the system to put the proposal or the progress report together. So that's great for existing funders. And actually, let me just give you a quick overview of what the system does, and then I'll show you a couple of key features. So from a nonprofit's perspective, PhilanTrack helps them find new sources of funding, helps them write better grant proposals more efficiently, ultimately get more grants and manage their relationships with their funders. So it helps them track their current and prospective funders, helps them track the grants that have been awarded so they can see what money is actually coming in and when, helps them actually write the proposals, and that's kind of the secret sauce that I'll get into a little bit, helps them do the reporting, and it actually gives them a document library so they can centrally store the documents that funders are frequently asking for. In terms of tracking funders, so let's look at just current funders. And again, I'll just show you a few features here. So the XYZ Foundation, we're very creative in our naming conventions here, so the XYZ Foundation. So for the XYZ Foundation, I can see basic contact information, but I can also see my organization's entire history with this funder. This is critically important because there's actually a lot of turnover in nonprofits. So as a development director, and development in the nonprofit world has to do with fundraising, not code, so just to be clear about that. So as a development directors leave, when the new person comes in, all of the organization's information is centrally stored rather than being on somebody's laptop. So that's great for current funders. For new funders, we have a couple of mechanisms for organizations to find new funders. One is through a partnership with a company called GrantStation. If I know that I'm looking for funding in Philadelphia for organizations that fund education, fund youth, I can go to GrantStation, search specifically for the types of organizations that will fund my type of organization, and then add those organizations to PhilanTrack. I can also add organizations by doing a lookup in PhilanTrack, and I'll tell you one thing that I unfortunately can't show you yet, but one of the really cool things that we're working on is building a predictive tool. So based on your organization's key characteristics and on the key characteristics of funders in your area, here are some organizations that you should approach to look for funding because they've funded organizations like yours in the past. It's going to save nonprofits a tremendous amount of time, and I'll love to show it to you in a few months. In the interim, though, if I want to add an organization to my list of funders, and let's say we're adding the Philadelphia Foundation, it's a fairly large local community foundation, this is looking up in the IRS database of exempt organizations. This verifies that the organization is actually a nonprofit, but it'll also pull out the key contact information for the Philadelphia Foundation. I can add them to my list of prospective funders and then go through the process of actually writing a proposal. So here's where the secret sauce comes in. The process of writing a proposal, you know, I mentioned that nonprofits are sort of pulling documents from here and there and pulling things together and trying to find the right language, and it could be in one place, it could be in another. Pending bit of our technology solves that problem. So when I'm writing a proposal to the Philadelphia Foundation, let's say I'm looking for funding for our education program from the Philadelphia Foundation, we'll just call it, it's a request for ongoing support. We're looking for capacity building grant. Let's say we're looking for a $25,000 grant to support our programs. I would probably write that in a slightly more compelling way. Say I know they have a due date upcoming. As long as I know what their requirements are, which I would know from looking at their website, if they're a user of our system, those requirements would be built into the system. A lot of cases, foundations don't have very specific requirements, and nonprofits will sort of build their boilerplate template. They can do that in PhilanTrack as well. So once I've added the proposal, I set a primary contact, that person is going to get the email reminders. Here's where the cool part comes in. So this is what a proposal looks like. In this case, the proposal includes the organization's mission statement, how does the program relate to the work of other organizations in the same area. This is fairly typical stuff that's being asked for in grant proposals. So rather than going and trying to figure out, I know I wrote something about this, I had a great way of phrasing it, where did I put that? I can click this Find Similar Questions button, see how I've been asked that question before by a funder in the past, see how I've answered that question, and then use this response and it populates that field. I can do that essentially for the entire proposal. I can edit these responses if I need to. But this saves a tremendous amount of time and also pulls in really consistent language, so it's really effectively building the capacity of the organizations. I can do that as well for financial information, so let me take a second to come up. And I'll say that this is our 2011 fiscal year. Funders are frequently asking for verification of your tax status, audited financial statements, whatever documents they may be asking me to append. I can pull those from their document library, attach it to the proposal, and then once I'm ready, and this is a very short example, proposals are typically much, much longer than this, but you can see how quick and easy it is to reuse existing information. I can tweak responses if I need to meet the needs of a particular funder. If a funder is asking me something I've never been asked before, that's fine. I can spend my time working on a great response to that question rather than reinventing the wheel for the stuff that I've already answered. Once I'm ready to submit this proposal, I can save it. I can come back to it another time if I so choose, but I can just download the PDF version of it and send it off to the funder. Just want to show you one other thing. You know, I mentioned that we sort of sit in the middle of the process. We have a set of tools for nonprofits and a set of tools for their funders. Just want to show you one cool tool that we have for the funders, which is, and actually, Sean, if you want to use this to help ensure that the organizations that are coming to PS Give are financially sound organizations, we can talk about that. What this tool does is take basic financial statements entered by applicants, by grant applicants, or by grantees, and it produces a series of analyses looking at the financial health and performance of the organization. So this is one of the things that funders have a very typically have a very difficult time evaluating. How is this organization actually faring financially? We essentially do that for them with this tool. So it's looking at everything from what are their different funding sources, to how are they spending their money, to, if you'll bear with me while I scroll back up top here, looking at their ability to service debt, which is particularly important in the current funding environment, looking at their liquidity, profitability, et cetera. And with this tool, we provide a little bit of support around why is this important, how can you use this in making your funding decisions. So I show this to you for two reasons. One is that it's just a cool tool that we have for foundations, but two is we have these great graphics generation capabilities that we're in the midst of sort of moving over to the foundation, rather the nonprofit side of the product. So we'll be adding more of these analytical tools to help nonprofits get ever more effective at their grant-seeking pursuits. The system is currently in use by about 1,450 organizations. The majority of them are using a free version of PhilanTrack, and we're in the midst of getting them onto an upgrade path to get them using a premium version, or get a subset of them using a premium version of the product. The funders that are using the system are using it to manage about $25 million in grants, and they love it. So essentially what we're doing is moving nonprofits from this to this. And if you work for a nonprofit, or if you know anybody who works for a nonprofit, you want to try it out, go to philantrack.com. You can sign up for a free trial. Use the promo code PTM. It'll give you 10% off the first year license if you're inclined to move in that direction. I do have two requests. The first is we are actively hiring. We're looking for Python developers. So if you are a Python developer or you know a Python developer, I would love to talk to you or love to talk to your friend. We're also always looking for intros to foundations, nonprofits that might be interested, governments that might be interested in using the system. So with that, I will be happy to take any questions. Great questions. So the two questions were, what do we do to help organizations that may have very narrow and possibly unpopular missions and focuses, the example of mental health organizations that typically have a harder time finding funding. The second question was, for our financial analysis tool, where are we actually getting that data from? I'll answer the second question first. So for the financial analysis tool, the information is being entered by the applicants. So that tool currently resides in our tool for foundations. As foundations move their grant application process online, what they do is ask a nonprofit to input a balance sheet and an income statement. That information then feeds the financial analysis tool. As a best practice, we always recommend that funders also get audited financial statements from their applicants, so it provides that type of check and balance. In terms of what we do to help organizations that may have unpopular missions, it's tough. It's certainly harder for some organizations to find funding than others. Currently, we have, I suppose, two approaches to that. One is through GrantStation. GrantStation is actually is a partner of ours, is a great tool for helping organizations find funding that's going to be very specific to whatever their mission is. What we're working on going forward, I mentioned the predictive model that we're building that will help based on a funder's past giving history. We're looking at a number of different criteria, given what a funder has funded in the past, to suggest that they may be interested in funding a given organization. We're also rolling out training that will help nonprofits get better at doing their own research that they can then use to feed into the tool as well. Absolutely, absolutely. So one was someone who has actually used the system and been mostly happy with it, so that's great. And the question was, you know, it's really useful to, when you're writing a grant application, to be able to print out the application before or download it just so you can see what the questions are. Let me tackle that first. You can actually do that. We probably need to make it a little bit more obvious. But as you're writing the proposal, there's a Save All and Preview button in the top right corner. When you click that Save All and Preview, you can, even if you haven't finished the proposal, you can download a Word or PDF version of it. The second question, foundations change. Foundation funding priorities change. So what they've funded in the past is not a predictor. It's sort of like financial markets. You know, past performance isn't an indication of future performance. That's very true, and honestly, we can't control for that. It's one of the reasons that we've partnered with GrantStation. They are a research company. They actually go out and look for currently available funding opportunities. They will call funders and say, what are you currently funding? So all of the data that we have access to that is actually forward-looking. And we're supplementing that with the backward-looking data that comes from the IRS and from other sources. That's a great question. So the question was, are we able to estimate how much it's going to be able to save nonprofits? We have not done a good enough job yet at really quantifying how much time is saved. We have some great anecdotal evidence at, you know, saving an hour per application. So nonprofits are typically spending over 20 hours per application. So even saving an hour in that process is significant. We think that it'll get up to 3 to 4 hours of savings. You know, there is still some research that needs to happen. There's still some writing that needs to happen. But that's one of our key questions going forward, is to be able to quantify that better than we have so far. Yep, that's a good question. So the question was, particularly for government agencies, it's true for some foundations as well, they may have their own format that may not necessarily mesh up with ours. And how do we interact with those systems? So two answers to that question. One is, the examples that I showed you were really, really generic, but you can actually do a reasonable amount of formatting in the system. A number of the systems that are in use by government agencies and by some foundations will say, use this format, and basically just upload a document. Since you can produce Word docs or PDF really easily from the system, you can use PhilanTrack to manage most of that process, then produce a document that you can upload. Ultimately, we're hoping that there's going to be a little bit more of a standard developed that we'll be able to speak to. We've been very, very open about that. We would love to play well with others if they were willing to play well with us. So it's a short-term challenge and something that we hope will get better in the long term as more organizations realize that there are efficiencies to be gained and more impact to be had by reducing the transaction costs. So the free version, so the question was, what's the difference between the free and the premium version? The free version, the way that we've structured things to date, grantees of our client foundations get free access to the basic tool. The basic tool is the ability to track your funders, to actually do the proposal writing, so that time savings is built in to the basic version. The premium version includes access to that research tool. It includes access to a training program that we're just in the midst of rolling out, which is both a little bit of training on how to use the software, but it's training on how to do better grant research and how to do better grant writing. And we're in the midst of working on this predictive model and a number of other tools that will all be part of the premium version. Yes, okay, so the question was about our business model and sources of income. So we license the tool to nonprofits that are paying for the premium version. We also license, and that's a monthly license, we also license the tool to foundations, which has been the majority source of our revenue to date. So for foundations, we do some implementation and customization as well, and then it's an annual license fee.
All right, time's up. One last question. How can the PhilanTrack community help you out?
Thank you. So always interested in introductions to nonprofits and foundations. And again, we're hiring. If you're a Python developer or you know a Rockstar Python developer, I would love to talk to you.
All right, give them our applause.